you still have to make time to run across a football field to score for the coach was intentional. The moment you started to fall in love with yourself because you are sometimes by yourself was intentional. As excellence, though it calls many, you will only a few responses. Leadership is the moment that your spirit becomes aware that as an eagle, you have no business seeking validation from chickens. It is that moment that has gotten you here. That moment is when you finally believe that you are greater than anything you have ever imagined. Veritas vos liberabi, the truth shall set you free. You know you're greater than the limitation of your physical sight because inside you lives an energy, a force that tells you that I am the same force that lived in Neil Armstrong, the first man to walk the moon. I am the same force that lived in the woman named Harriet Tubman, who went back and forth to the South 19 times by foot, over 1,000 miles, to free 300 slaves over a 10-year period, and told her narcolepsy, I can't deal with you right now. Amen. Understand, I will not suddenly fall asleep on the job of serving humanity, because generations depend on me staying awake. History depends on me staying awake. A nation depends on me staying awake. I am the same force that live in Malala Yousafzai, the youngest recipient of the Nobel Peace Prize, who was shot in the head because she advocated for young girls' education in Pakistan, who did not quit and run away, but boldly told the world, they can shoot me down, but nothing changed in my life except that weakness, fear, and hopelessness died, while strength, power, and courage took their rightful place. I am that same force that lives in you. See yourself so others can see you. In the words of Marianne Williamson, we're all meant to shine like children do. Be of service to yourself by serving the world. I'm going to end by telling you a story. I love stories. Do you love stories?
Yes.
There was a little girl who at the age of 4 was sent to live with her paternal grandmother in the mountains, away from the seashore of her home. This was done because her grandmother was a master teacher and a no-nonsense woman. Education was the only language to be spoken. In rural Jamaica, going to the well to fetch water, waiting for the milkman to finish milking the cow, to attain the pints of milk purchased was the norm, as was chasing goats and not tipping cows. Another normal for the little girl was as early as 8 years old to be up at 4 and 5 a.m. studying for the common entrance exam, the exam in Jamaica given once a year that would determine the education route of study, hence having an impact on your entire future. Many a night during storms and no storms, electricity would go out. And the little girl would keep on studying, as her grandma would light the lanterns, as comfort was not an ingredient for success.
Yes.
Day after day, she would watch her friends play while she studied. She had a companion, though, because as she studied, and discipline unknowingly became a part of her DNA, she would hear the words spoken too often by her grandmother. The heights of great men
reached and kept were not attained
by sudden flight.
And even
but they, while their companions slept,
were twirling upward
through the night. She hated that saying. After a while, she just became sick of that saying. Nevertheless, she aced her exam and went on to one of the best schools in Jamaica. But not too long after, she migrated to America at 14 years old to be with her mother. Hell met her at the gate of Bedford Stuyvesant, Brooklyn, where she was thrusted into the arms of a harsh reality of a crime and drug-infested neighborhood. School was her only escape. Even when her mom threw her to the ground to escape a stray bullet that came crashing through their window. She was all too happy when Boston University welcomed her, and later the University of Miami School of Law. But another hell awaited her. Money was nowhere to be found. At times, she lived off water and bread. And if she was lucky, she was able to afford cup and noodle to get her through. She would walk miles in the Miami heat to get to law school, as the only thing that kept her going was comfort was not an ingredient for success. Mm-hmm. Despite challenges, she had come from a line of women where distinction was found in the determination to succeed, the determination to get the next generation further than the one before by following the light of their torch. She knew she would have to make some more sacrifices, as although the American Bar Association required no more than 20 hours a week while being a law school full-time student, she would have to break that rule. As others went out, she studied. While others played on South Beach, she studied, prayed, and studied some more. Her grandmother prayed, her mama prayed, the whole family prayed. She went back to New York. She studied 14 hours a day for 10 weeks straight for the New York Bar. At the celebration of her passing, she heard the same voice she had heard so long ago as a little girl. The same force of love, the same ingredient passed on along from porch to porch. She cried as the words echoed softly from across the room. The heights of great men reach and kept were not attained by student flight, but they, while their companions slept, march on upward through the night. She buried her grandmother a few months ago, but echoed the same words to her son as she does to you now. May your torch that rises from the pages of your open book of education never go dark. May the spirit of the resilience that you have met behind the walls of Calvin Coolidge High School embrace you and always accompany you. Congratulations to the class of 2016, and congratulations to those who have truly grasped that this is not the end, but the beginning of something worth fighting for, that something which is your future.